Obama hid nearly half a million docs about bin Laden raid to ensure election. Is there any shady trick or scheme Democrat politicians won't use to try to stay in power? Just days ago, a bombshell story shows that Hillary Clinton used mobster tactics to bully the DNC and secure the 2016 nomination. Now, a new report is shining the spotlight on questionable actions that Barack Obama took to skew public opinion in his favor during the 2012 race against Mitt Romney. In a detailed exposé in the Weekly Standard, journalist and author Stephen F. Hayes shows that Obama buried a staggering number of documents from Osama bin Laden's compound, and essentially lied to the American people about the real status of al-Qaeda in order to win votes. Finally, thanks to the Trump administration, those documents are now coming to light. A key piece of Obama's re-election was the elimination of bin Laden and the claim that the administration had al-Qaeda on the run. Afghanistan was won, the incumbent president boasted, and Islamic terrorism was waning. The path forward was to lift sanctions on Iran and move forward. There was one big problem: the administration knew it wasn't true, but repeated it anyway. The self-proclaimed most transparent administration in history had spent more than 5 years, by 2016, misleading the American people about the threat from al-Qaeda and its offshoots and had paid very little price for having done so, Hayes explained. When the CIA and Navy SEALs raided bin Laden's compound in Pakistan, they brought back cases upon cases of documents, along with hard drives that contained gigabytes of important intelligence. At the time of the raid, National Security Advisor Tom Donilon described those documents as enough to fill a small college library. Despite the vast amount of information taken from the terrorist mastermind, the Obama administration chose to release only the pieces that they wanted. More specifically, they only showed journalists the documents that made Barack Obama look good, while hiding the rest. In the spring of 2012, with the Republican presidential primaries nearing an end and shortly before the first anniversary of the successful raid on bin Laden's compound, Obama's National Security Council handpicked 17 documents to be provided to the Combating Terrorism Center at West Point for analysis, the Weekly Standard revealed. That's 17 out of a cache of around 470,000 documents, or less than 0.003% of the full picture. The West Point documents were shared with Obama-friendly journalists. Their conclusion was the only one possible, given the documents they were provided. At the time of his death, Osama bin Laden was frustrated and isolated, a relatively powerless leader of a dying organization, the article continued. Of course, that's exactly the impression that Barack Obama wanted the American people to have in the run-up to the election. In the summer and fall of 2012, Obama would use this theme as the main national security rationale for his re-election. Al-Qaeda was alternately on the run or decimated or on the path to defeat. Hidden away in the stack of documents that the administration kept secret, however, a very different reality lay buried. Some documents shows that Al-Qaeda was adapting to the U.S.'s efforts to eliminate its leaders. Perhaps more importantly, the newly released documents also showed that the terrorist group was forming close alliances with Iran, the same nation that Barack Obama wanted to extend an olive branch to during his second term. Revealing to the American people the truth about Osama bin Laden's cozy working relationship with the Iranian government might have fatally undermined that diplomatic quest, just as the ongoing vitality of al-Qaeda, amply testified to in the bin Laden documents, would have contradicted Obama's proud claims in 2012 that al-Qaeda was on the run, summarized the Standard. So Obama, with the eager cooperation of some in the intelligence community, bottled up the bin Laden documents and ran out the clock. Instead of calling out the country of Iran for having increasingly close ties to al-Qaeda and the bin Laden family in particular, Barack Obama pretended that they were America's new best friends. He drafted the Iran nuclear deal to give the regime a path to dangerous nuclear capabilities, while sweeping the Iran-al-Qaeda connections under the rug. In short, the Obama administration did exactly what so many liberals accused the Bush administration of doing before the Iraq invasion: skew intelligence and hide known facts in order to justify a policy that made the president look good. Obama promised the most transparent administration in history when he first took office. It looks like in a few short years, his presidency instead changed to one of the most opaque and deceitful in recent memory. And he has a lot of explaining to do to the American people. Please press share on Facebook if you're fed up with the DC swamp, and Barack Obama.